bastard, orphan, son of a whore and a Scotsman, dropped in the middle of a forgotten spot in the Caribbean by Providence, impoverished and squalor. Grow up to be a hero and a scholar. The $10 founding father without a father got a lot farther by working a lot harder, by being a lot smarter, by being a self-starter. By 14, they placed him in charge of a trading charter. And every day while slaves were being slaughtered and carted away across the waves, he struggled and kept his guard up. Inside he was longing for something to be a part of. The brother was ready to beg, steal, borrow, or barter. Then a hurricane came, devastation rained. A man saw his future drip, dripping down the drain. Put a pencil to his temple, connected it to his brain, and he wrote his first refrain, a testament to his pain. Well, the word got around, they said, this kid is insane, man. Took up a collection just to send him to the mainland. Get your education, don't forget from whence you came, and the world's gonna know your name. What's your name, man? Alexander Hamilton. It's Alexander Hamilton. And there's a million things I haven't done, but just you wait, just you wait.
When he was 10, his father's clip full of it, debt ridden. 2 years later, see Alex and his mother bedridden, half dead, sticking their own sick descent thick.
And Alex got better, but his mother went quick. Moved in with the cousin committed suicide. Left him with nothing but ruined pride. Something new inside a boy saying, Alex, you gotta fend for yourself. He started retreating and reading every treatise on the shelf. There would've been nothing left to do for someone less astute. He would've been dead and destitute without a cent to restitution. Started working, working for his late mother's landlord. Traded sugar cane and rum and all the things he can't afford.